Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace goodwill to men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace goodwill to men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace goodwill to men. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on us. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on us. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on us sinners. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Foundation so that it should never be shaken. The deep covers it like a garment, the water stood above the mountains. At your rebuke they fled, at the voice of your thunder they were afraid. The mountains ascended, the valleys sank down to the place which you appointed for them. You have set a boundary which the seas shall not pass, nor shall they return to cover the earth. He sends the springs into the valleys, the waters flow among the hills. All the beasts of the field drink thereof, the wild asses quench their thirst. Beside them the birds of the air have the habitation, their voices resound amid the rocks. He waters the mountains from his upper chambers, and the earth is filled with the fruit of your work. He causes the grass to grow for the cattle, and the herbs for the service of man, and he may bring forth food from the earth, and wine to make glad the heart of man, oil to make his face shine, and bread to strengthen man's heart. The trees of the field are full of sap, even the cedars of Lebanon which he has planted. There the birds make their nest, the abode of the stork is foremost among them. The high hills are refuge for the wild goats, the rocks are refuge for the hyrax. He appointed the moon for the seasons, and the sun as its time for setting. He made darkness, and it is night, wherein all the beasts of the forest did move. The young lions were after their prey, seeking their food from God. When the sun arises, they gather together and lie down in their dens. Man goes forth to his work and to his labor until the evening. O Lord, how magnified are your works and wisdom you have made them all. The earth is filled with your creation. Behold, the sea great and wide, in which are teeming things innumerable, living things both small and great. There go the ships and that Leviathan which you fashioned to play therein. These all look to you that you may give them their food in due season. When you give it to them, they gather it. When you open your hand, they are filled with good things. When you hide your face, they are troubled. When you take away their breath, they die and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in his works. He looks on the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God while I am my being. May my words be pleasing to him. I will be glad in the Lord. May sinners be consumed out of the earth and awaken me no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The sun knows its time for setting. You make darkness and it is night. O Lord, how magnified are your works and wisdom you have made them all. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God.
Blessed is the man.
Planted by water. This is my king installed by me on Zion, my holy mountain. Let me proclaim the Lord's decree. He had told me, you are my son, today I have become your father. Ask and I will give you the nations for your heritage, the ends of the earth for your domain. With iron scepter you will break them, shatter them like potter's ware. So now you kings, learn wisdom, earthly rulers, be warned. Serve the Lord with fear and trembling, pay of your homage, alleluia.
Serve the Lord with fear and trembling, pay of your homage, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Kiss his feet or he will be angry, he will perish for his anger, so he put to blaze. Blessed are they who put their trust in God, alleluia.
Blessed are they who put their trust in God, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now, never, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia. Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Lord, my God, in thee I take refuge. Save me from all my pursuers and deliver me. Lest like a lion they rend me, dragging me away with none to rescue. O Lord, my God, if I have done this, if there is wrong in my hands, if I have requited my friends as evil, or plundered my enemy without cause, let the enemy pursue me and overtake me, and let him trample my life to the ground and lay my soul in the dust. Arise, O Lord, in my anger, lift thyself up against the fear of my enemies. Awake, O my God, thus appointed a judgment. Let the assembly of the peoples be gathered about thee and overtake thy seat on high. The Lord judges the peoples. Judge me, O Lord, according to my righteousness and according to the integrity that is in me. Let the evil of the wicked come to an end, but establish thou the righteous. Thou who triest the minds and hearts, thou righteous God. My shield is with God, who saves the upright in heart. God is a righteous judge and a God who has indignation every day. If a man does not repent, God will whet his sword. He has bent and strung his bow. He has prepared his deadly weapons, making his arrows fiery shafts. Behold, the wicked man conceives evil and is pregnant with mischief and brings forth lies. He makes a pit, digging it out, and falls into the hole which he has made. His mischief returns upon his own head, and on his own pate his violence descends. O, a gift to the Lord, the thanks due to his righteousness, I will sing praise to the name of the Lord Most High. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is thy name in all the earth. Thou whose glory above the heavens is chanted by the mouth of babes and infants. Thou hast founded a bulwark because of thy foes to still the enemy and the avenger. When I look at thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast established, what is man that thou art mindful of him, and the son of man that thou dost care for him? Yet thou hast made him little less than God, and hast crowned him with glory and honor. Thou hast given him dominion over the works of thy hands. Thou hast put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, majestic is thy name in all the earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory be to you, O God.
Divine.
shall redeem Israel from all his iniquities.
Forever setting sun presses forward to rise, enlightening all things under heaven. Let us hasten with clean hands and pure deeds to meet. Good.
King bold in majesty.
Pursued them as far as Hobah, which is north of Damascus. So he brought back all the goods and also brought back his brother Lot and his goods, as well as the women and the people. And the king of Sodom went out to meet him at the valley of Shaveh, that is the king's valley, after his return from the defeat of Kedar Laomer and the kings who were with him. Then Melchizedek, king of Salem, brought out bread and wine. He was the priest of God Most High. And he blessed him and said, blessed be Abram of God Most High, possessor of heaven and earth. And blessed be God Most High, who has delivered your enemies into your hand. And he gave him a tithe of all.
The reading is from the book of Deuteronomy. See, I have set the land before you. Go in and possess the land which the Lord swore to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give to them and their descendants after them. And I spoke to you at that time, saying, I alone am not able to bear you. The Lord your God has multiplied you, and here you are today as the stars of heaven in multitude. May the Lord God of your fathers make you 1,000 times more numerous than you are, and bless you as he has promised you. So I took the heads of your tribes, wise and knowledgeable men, and made them heads over you, leaders of thousands, leaders of hundreds, leaders of fifties, leaders of tens, and officers for your tribes. Then I commanded your judges at that time, saying, hear the cases between your brethren, and judge righteously between a man and his brother, or the stranger who is with him. You shall not show partiality in judgment. You shall hear the small as well as the great. You shall not be afraid in any man's presence, for the judgment is God's. The case that is too hard for you, bring to me, and I will hear it.
Reading it from the book of Deuteronomy. Indeed, heaven and the highest heavens belong to the Lord your God, also the earth with all that is in it. The Lord delights only in your fathers to love them, and he chose their descendants after them, you above all peoples, as it is this day. Therefore circumcise the foreskin of your heart, and be stiff-necked no longer. For the Lord your God is God of gods and Lord of lords, the great God, mighty and awesome, who shows no partiality nor takes a bribe. He administers justice for the fatherless and the widow, and loves the stranger, giving him food and clothing. Therefore love the stranger, for you were strangers in the land of Egypt. You shall fear the Lord your God, you shall serve him, and to him you shall hold fast and take oaths in his name. He is your praise, and he is your God, who has done for you these great and awesome things which your eyes have seen.
Thou safe, O Lord, keep us this evening without sin. Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is your name forever. Amen. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us as we have set our hope on you. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Blessed are you, O Master, make me to understand your statutes. Blessed are you, Holy One, enlighten me with your statutes. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not the works of your hands. To you is due praise, to you is due a song, to you is due glory. To the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, Visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Through the prayers of our Holy Fathers, the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Those who rendered me evil for good slandered me because I followed after good.
Do not forsake me, O Lord my God. Depart not from me. Attend to my help, O Lord of my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord my God. Depart not from me. Attend to my help, O Lord of my salvation. O God, my God, early in the morning I turn to you. My soul thirsts for you. Often my flesh longs for you as in a trackless desert land where no water is. So I have appeared before you in the sanctuary to see your power and glory. Because your mercy is better than life, my lips will praise you. Thus I will bless you while I live. I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul will be filled as with oil, and fat to my mouth will praise you with joyful lips. I remembered you upon my bed. I meditated on you in the morning, for you have been my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will rejoice. My soul has cleaved to you, your right hand upholds me. But those who sought my life in vain, they shall be delivered up to the sword. They shall be a portion for foxes. But the king shall rejoice in God, everyone who swears by him shall be praised, but the mouth of those who speak unrighteousness shall be stopped. I meditated on you in the morning, for you have been my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will rejoice. My soul is cleaved to you, your right hand upholds me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God of my salvation, I have cried out today and night before you. Let my prayer come before you, and incline your ear to my supplication. For my soul is full of troubles, and my life draws near to hell. I am captive with those who go down to the pit. I have become like a man without help, free among the dead, like the slain who lie in the grave, who you remember no more, and who are cut off from your hand. You have laid me in the lowest pit, in darkness, and in the shadow of death. You have placed heavy upon me, and you have afflicted me with all your waves. You have put away my acquaintances far from me, and they regard me with horror. I was delivered up and have not come forth. My eyes are weakened from weeping. Lord, I have called daily upon you. I have stretched out my hands to you. Will you work wonders for the dead? Will the shades rise up and praise you? Who will tell of your mercy in the grave, or your righteousness in the place of destruction? Will your wonders be known in the darkness, and your truth in the land of forgetfulness? But to you I have cried out, O Lord, and in the morning my prayer comes before you. O Lord, why do you cast off my soul? Why do you turn away your face from me? I am poor and in distress from my youth. I was exalted, then I was humiliated and brought very low. Your wrath passed over me, your terrors troubled me like water. They engulfed me all day long, they overwhelmed me. You have put far away from me my friends, my neighbors, and my acquaintances because of my sufferings. O Lord, God of my salvation, I have cried out day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you, and incline your ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from corruption, who crowns you with mercy and compassion, who satisfies your desire with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord works deeds of mercy and executes justice for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, his will to the children of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, long-suffering and abundant in mercy. He will not always be angry, nor will he be at enmity with us forever. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, the Lord has confirmed his mercy on those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgression from us. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord is compassionate to those who fear him. For he knows whereof we are made, and remembers that he heard us. As for man, his days are like grass, like the flower of the field, so he blossoms. For when the wind passes over it, it is gone, and its place remembers it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness to children's children, to those who keep his covenant and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord has prepared his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all his angels, mighty in strength, who do his word, heeding the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all his hosts, his ministers, who do his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, and all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. In all places of his dominion, bless the Lord, my soul. Hear my prayer, O Lord, give ear to my supplication in your faithfulness. Hear me in your righteousness, enter not into judgment with your servant. For in your sight, no man living shall be justified. For the enemy has persecuted my soul, he has humbled my life to the ground, he has made me dwell in darkness like those who have long been dead. Therefore my spirit is overwhelmed within me, my heart within me is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all your works, I mused on the works of your hands, I spread out my hands to you, my soul longed for you like a thirsty lamb. Hear me speedily, O Lord, my spirit fails, turn not your face from me, lest I be like those who go down into the pit. Make me to hear your mercy in the morning, for in you I have hoped. Make me to know, O Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I have lifted up my soul to you. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, for to you I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. For your namesake, O Lord, enlighten me in your Righteousness, bring my soul out of tribulation. In your mercy, cut off my enemies and destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant. Hear me in your righteousness, enter not into judgment with your servant. Hear me in your righteousness, enter not into judgment with your servant. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Joseph, and let us faithfully cry out,
O God, bearing forefathers, entreat Christ God that he grant remission of sins unto them that with love celebrate your holy memory.
Oh,
Joshua and the 12 patriarchs, together with the three youths that quench the fiery flame with the power of the Spirit. And let us cry out to them, rejoice, ye that bravely denounce the deception of the mad king. Pray to Christ that he grant remission of offenses unto them that celebrate your holy memory with love. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the age of ages. Amen. From the bosom of the Father you came down, and in your ineffable condescension you took upon poverty like unto ours, in a manner surpassing nature, the lover of mankind. It was that our good pleasure to make your abode. It was our good pleasure to make your abode in the cave, O Lord. And like as a babe, you suckled at your mother's breast. Who are Creator and Lord, wherefore the Magi, guided by the star, bring gifts unto you and cry out, glory in highest to God, who comes to earth to be born as a man.
Share these indefinitely with Sister Christine.
Hardest thing have carried me since I was young, I call you, O my Savior, protect and save.
May they all be thrown into confusion, be routed, who have hated Zion, be blasted by winds from the east like grass sprouting on the roof.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Through the Holy Spirit, every soul is vivified, and by cleansing is exalted and enlightened by the Trinity through a mystical sanctification.
From the depths of my soul I call to you, O Lord. Lord, may your divine ear listen to my cry for help.
He that puts his hope in God is more highly perfected than those who despair.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and on, to the ages of ages. Amen. From the Holy Spirit, fountains of grace flow forth, watering all creation to generate fruits of new life.
Let my heart be lifted to you, O Word of God, and not be deceived by the beauty of this world, which pulls me down and binds me to the earth.
As one has love for his mother, then how much more fervent must be his love for God.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Through the Holy Spirit is the fullness of the knowledge of God, contemplation of holy things and wisdom, for through him the dogmas about the Word were revealed to all holy fathers.
The
proclaiming
on the fourth
Psalm.
Christ, come to my help, redeem us for the sake of first also went in, and he saw, and
he believed. For as yet they did not know the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to their homes.
Spirit, come to the children, he that is gloriously praised. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. The children that cast down godlessness in the furnace are in number and faith images of the divine Trinity, and they have revealed to the world the hidden mysteries of God. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. Abraham was delivered from the hands of the unrighteous, and the divine youths and Daniel the prophet were once saved from the flame of the furnace and from the den of wild beasts. Wherefore we now celebrate the four feasts of the Nativity of Christ. Most holy Theotokos, save us. O joyous and unwedded mother, incorrupt virgin, we bless you, for you did blossom forth from the generation of Abraham and the tribe of David, and gave birth unto Christ, who of old was foretold by the prophets.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. The virgin doth now come to Bethlehem to give birth to Christ, who becometh a babe in the flesh, to Christ, who of his own will hath beggared himself, to Christ, who becometh visible, let heaven and earth rejoice. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. Leap up, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Leap up, ye mountains and hills, join chorus, ye divinely eloquent prophets, ye people and nations, clap your hands. Our salvation and enlightenment, who is born in the city of Bethlehem, hath nearly come. Now and ever and unto ages of ages, amen. God is known as man through the virgin who hath not known wedlock. He that is rich becometh poor, enriching them that through malice have been reduced to poverty. Let us all hymn him with praises, for he hath been glorified.
Christ is born, give glory. Christ comes from heaven, go to meet him. Christ is upon earth, be exalted. Sing to the Lord of the earth, and all you peoples raise up in one joy, for he has been glorified.
Creation, beholding thee, who suspended the whole earth without support upon the waters, thyself hanging upon Golgotha, was seized with great awe, crying out, none is holy save thee, O Lord. Glory, O Lord, to thy holy resurrection. Having spent 3 days in the tomb, by thy life-creating resurrection, thou didst raise up the dead of ages past. And loosed from condemnation, they rejoiced with gladness, crying out, behold, thou hast come as our deliverance, O Lord. Glory, O Lord, to thy holy resurrection. Glory to thy rising, O our Savior, for as almighty you have delivered us from Hades, corruption, and death. And crying out, we say, none is holy save thee, O lover of mankind. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. Faithfully preserving the glory of the image and likeness of God with the fire of the Spirit, the children as champions extinguish the fire of the golden image, chanting, we know but one Lord. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. The captive children, clothed with the wisdom and power of the Spirit, put to shame the wise men of Babylon, and boldly cried out, none is holy save thee, O Lord, lover of mankind. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. The law rejoices and joins chorus with the children and the prophets and exults today before the divine ascent of the Lord. And Abraham rejoices, for from his seed hath the incarnate Lord appeared. Most holy Theotokos, save us. A conception without pain and acceptance of thy birth-giving has transpired in manner beyond recounting, O Theotokos. For the word of God, who is God and was proclaimed by the prophets, has shown himself to be a mystery beyond nature.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. He that in manner beyond understanding was born of the Father before the ages, hath become incarnate of the Virgin in latter times, as he himself knew, wishing to renew humanity, which had become corrupt through the counsel of the evil servant. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. The unoriginate Son of God, who is enthroned with the Father and the Spirit in the highest, beholding human nature which had been humbled, doth accept the beginning, and wisheth to be born in the flesh's man. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. She that is more holy than the angels and all creation doth now give birth without seed to the angel of great counsel in the flesh, for the restoration of all that unceasingly chant unto him, holy art thou, O Lord.
To the Son begotten of the Father, without change before the ages, and in this last wise, without sin made flesh from a virgin, to Christ God let us cry aloud, you have raised up our word, holy are you, O Lord.
mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
An angel bedewed the children in the furnace and has now put an end to the lamentation of the myrrh-bearing women, saying, Why bring ye myrrh? Whom seek ye in the tomb? Christ God is risen, for he is the life and salvation of the human race.
A homily by St. Nicholas Zichev in the prologue. On the birth of the Lord, the Son of God. From John's Gospel we read, I came forth from the Father and am come into the world. The only begotten Son of God, my brethren, begotten in eternity of the Father without a mother, was born in time of a mother without a father. That first begetting is an unfathomable mystery of the Holy Trinity in eternity. And the second birth is an unfathomable mystery of God's power and love for mankind in time. The greatest mystery in time corresponds to the greatest mystery in eternity. Without probing with the light of our small understanding into this greatest of mysteries, let us be content, my brothers and sisters, with the discovery that our salvation had its origin not from men, nor from the earth, but from the greatest heights of the invisible divine world. Such is God's mercy, and such is man's greatness. Such is God's mercy, and such is man's greatness, that God, the Son, himself came down from eternity into time, from heaven to earth, from the throne of glory to the shepherd's cave, solely, only to save man, to cleanse him from sin, to lead him back to paradise. I came forth from the Father, where he had everything, and am come into the world that could give him nothing. The Lord was born in a cave to show that the whole world is a dark cave that only he can illumine. The Lord was born in Bethlehem, the house of bread, to show that he is the only bread of life, worthy of true men. O Lord Jesus Christ, the pre-eternal Son of the living God and Son of the Virgin Mary, enlighten us and nourish us with thyself. To thee be glory and praise forever. Amen. To ponder, let me ponder on the beauty of the Most Holy Mother of God. Her soul was spotless, filled with light. Her soul was filled with peace, springing from faith and hope in God. Her soul was filled with the fragrance of prayer. Again, let me ponder on the beauty of the Most Holy Mother of God. Her soul was spotless and filled with light. Her soul was filled with peace, springing from faith and hope in God, and how her soul was filled with the fragrance of prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, who are coming in the flesh to save me, have mercy on me.
Foreseeing by divine condescension upon the cross, Habakkuk cried out in awe, Thou hast cut down the dominion of the mighty, O good one, entering into fellowship with them that are in Hades, as thou art almighty. Glory, O Lord of the holy resurrection. Thy divine descent into hell, O Christ God, was shown to be life for the dead, for thou hast restricted the dominion of the enemy below, O good one, and didst open a path for men to heaven. Glory, O Lord, to the holy resurrection. The all-pure body of the deliverer which lay in the tomb did not decay, but is mighty, thou didst break down the gates of Hades and didst rise again in glory on the third day, O Christ. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Let us honor Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob as the first fruits of the fathers, for from their seed has Christ shown forth incarnate of the Virgin, in that he is almighty. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Indicating the coming events of the descent of Christ unto all, Daniel clearly showed forth lions as sheep, for as a prophet of God he foresaw the future. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Not attracted by the poison of sin, O children, you were delivered from the flame. For being of wisdom more pure than gold, you were not melted in the furnace of deception. Most holy Theotokos, save us. O honored and all pure one, thine offspring who surpasses nature is proclaimed aloud to be the expectation of the nations and the salvation of the world. And today the multitude of fathers gives him.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. Thou hast given rise unto a staff from the root of Jesse, O Virgin, putting forth the unfading blossom of the Creator of all, who is God, doth adorn with flowers all the earth, which crieth aloud to him, glory to thy power, O Lord. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O Word of God, thou hast come to edify me, who have been despoiled through evil food, and dragged down in mind, and made like unto dumb beasts. And becoming a babe, thou dost lie down in a manger of dumb beasts. Glory to thy power, O Lord. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Jesus, Habakkuk foresaw the incarnate of the Virgin, the mountain overshadowed, breaking down the mountains and hills of evil, and giving over to utter destruction the arrogance of the evil one and the uprisings of the demons.
Brought out of Jesse's fruit and flower that blossomed from his stem, a promise you have sprung from the Virgin, the praise from the mountain overshadowed by forest. You have come, made flesh from her who knew not wedlock, yet God not form of matter. Glory to your power, O Lord.
Isaiah, rising at dawn and at the night, and beholding the unwaning light of that theophany of Christ, which has mercifully come to pass for us, cried out, the dead shall rise up, and they that are in the tomb shall arise, and all born on earth shall rejoice. Glory, O Lord, to thy holy resurrection. The angel, manifestly symbolizing that which radiates joy, is shown forth as a light-bearer in the tomb, proclaiming the resurrection to the women. And setting aside their lamentation, they rejoiced in the risen Christ, from whom they received unending joy. Glory, O Lord, to the holy resurrection. O good one, who in thy loving kindness assumed a form like ours, thou wast willingly nailed to the cross for the sake of me, who of old in paradise rejected thy holy commandment for the sake of food. And thou hast died as a man, granting me life. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Let us honor today the divine Daniel of the race of Abraham, the first fruit of the fathers as a leader of the law and of grace. For as a prophet of God, he foretold the advent of Christ from the Virgin and goes forth to meet his divine nativity. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Clearly prefiguring through the angel's descent the coming of the Lord unto us, the children of Abraham extinguished the furnace, and rendering the flame dewy with their faith, they consumed the splendor of the golden image therein. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Through the Spirit, Daniel closed to the mouths of the wild beasts in the pit, and through grace, the children of Abraham quenched the strength of the fire, and saved from corruption, they proclaimed Christ who is born of the Virgin, entreating him as the deliverer of our salvation. Most holy Theotokos, save us. Revealing through the divine spirit thy painless assumption of our nature, and keeping vigil in the law of grace, O Lord, Isaiah cried out, from the race of Abraham and the tribe of Judah does a virgin come, giving birth in the flesh without seed.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, the most perfect Son of God, the Master by nature, in his loving kindness, who was well pleased to be called the Son of Man, and reckoned among slaves a most compassionate one. Wherefore, willingly beggaring thyself, thou comest to be born in a cave, O all good one. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O Christ our King, who art uncontainable by nature. How can a little cave receive thee? How can a manger contain thee, who comest in the flesh to thine own for our sake? From a mother that knewest not wedlock, that thou mightest save them that have been estranged from thee, O Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. The shepherd's ewe lamb hath come to give birth. Make ready, O holy cave. Make haste, ye shepherds, to see the newborn shepherd and lamb. Ye magi, prepare yourself with gifts to worship him as king in the flesh.
As you are God of peace and Father of mercies, you have sent us your angel of great counsel who grants us peace. So we are guided by the knowledge of God, watching before dawn.
my life from corruption, O most merciful one. Glory, O Lord, to the holy resurrection. By thy three-day burial, O good one, thou didst bring about the mortification of death and the destruction of hell. And having risen, O good Jesus, in godly manner, thou hast poured forth life upon them that are in the world. Holy Father, pray to God for us. Hospitable was the nature, and exalted was the faith of Abraham the forefather. Wherefore, receiving in image the divine mystery, he rejoiced. And running before Christ, he now maketh merry. Holy Father, pray to God for us. The faith of the youths now holds creation subject by the gift of the Creator. For the all-devouring and shameless fire stood in awe of them that honor Jesus Christ, the Creator of fire. Holy Father, pray to God for us. Daniel the prophet, once closing the mouths of the lions in the pit, showed in godly manner that through the coming of Christ, the savagery of the world is in harmony with divine peace. Most holy Theotokos, save us. O Mary, Mother, who knewest not man, from a virgin womb didst thou give birth unto Christ, whom the prophets beheld in the Spirit, and the fathers who begot him now join chorus before his nativity.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. O Mistress, as thou art in new heaven, thou dost come, that Christ, the Son of Glory, might shine forth in the flesh from thy womb, as through a cloud in the cave. For in his boundless loving kindness he wisheth to splendidly to illumine all that are of this earth with rays of his own light. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. Thou didst perceive our infirmity and misery, O compassionate Christ, and didst not disdain us, but without leaving the Father, thou didst empty thyself and make thine abode in the womb of her that kneweth not wedlock, who now cometh forth to give birth unto thee without pain in the cave. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Ye mountain hills, fields and vales, peoples and generations, nations and every creature, exult, filled with divine gladness, for the deliverance of all, the Word of God, the timeless One, who in his loving kindness hath come under time, doth come with haste.
The monster from the deep sun, Jonah from its paws, like a newborn babe, just as it had received him, while the Word having dwelt in the Virgin and taken flesh, came forth and kept her in corrupt, for being himself not subject to decay, he preserved his mother free from harm.
Lord, mercy, Lord, mercy, Lord, mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages and ages. Amen.
Be glad, O Bethlehem, make ready, O Ephrathah, for lo, she that beareth the Lamb and great shepherd in her womb doth make haste to give birth. Beholding this, the God-bearing fathers are glad with the shepherds, hymning the nursing virgin. Beholding the splendid radiance of thy birth-giving, O Virgin, the God-loving Abraham, the ever-memorable Isaac, Jacob, and all the divinely assembled choir of saints rejoice, and with joyous utterances they lead creation forth to meet thee. For thou art shown to be the mediatress of joy for all, having conceived in thy womb him that once was seen in Babylon, who preserved and unconsumed the youth that had been cast unjustly into the furnace, and who showed thee forth in a manner past all comprehension. Wherefore the young maidens chant unto him that is born in thine arm, giving thee as the nursing virgin.
A homily on the righteous Joseph by St. Nikolai Pazicha. Joseph, her husband, a just man, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him. Matthew 1. One must fear God more than men, and listen to God rather than to men. This is the reason of the life of the righteous Joseph, the kinsman and protector of the Holy Virgin Mary. He lived at the turning point of the law and grace, and was faithful to the law until grace appeared. Then, when the new grace of God appeared, he became faithful to grace. Obedient to the letter of the law, he wanted to put the Holy Virgin away when she conceived the Savior of the world in her pure body. But when the angel of God revealed to him that Mary had conceived by the Holy Spirit, he abandoned his intention and did not put her away, but did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He did not reason for himself, but hearkened to the will of God. Therefore God made him worthy of great glory, both of earth on earth and in heaven. Quietly and secretly, Joseph obeyed God, God glorified him openly. Not only was he worthy of the kingdom of God, but also his sons and daughters. What more could a father want than that his sons should become apostles of Christ? And Joseph had two sons who became apostles. Thus did God glorify those who fear him and hearken to him. O great Lord, the God of righteous Joseph, help us sinners to love thy righteousness and to fear thee alone. To thee be glory and praise forever. Amen.
O ineffable wonder, he that in the furnace delivered the venerable children from the flame is laid in the grave, dead and devoid of breath, for the salvation of us that chant, O God, our deliverer, blessed art thou. Glory, O Lord, to the holy resurrection. O strange wonder, the Lord who sits upon a throne in the highest in assuming flesh has endured death, but he has arisen through the might of the Godhead, raising with himself the dead of ages past. Glory, O Lord, to thy holy resurrection. Thou didst shake the might of death and didst rise again, granting the resurrection unto them that truly glorify thee, the Lord, and that chant unto thee with orthodox faith, O God, our deliverer, blessed art thou. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. O Father Abraham, founder of thy race, having begotten Christ in the flesh, thou art clearly revealed by the Spirit as the Father of nations, unto the salvation of us that chant, O God, our deliverer, blessed art thou. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. The hymn of the inspired ones has put to shame them that utter soulless noises, for the youths bodily trampling down unharmed the furnace which burnt with fire chant, O God, our deliverer, blessed art thou. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. Of old, the prophet Daniel, gazing with spiritual vision, revealed the second coming of Christ, and he foretells the dreadful things which shall come to pass therein, crying out, O God, our deliverer, blessed art thou. Most holy Theotokos, save us. O strange wonder, known among the prophets and revealed of old to the fathers, a pure virgin is come, wishing to give birth unto the salvation of us who chant, O God, our deliverer, blessed art thou.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, the divine vine whereon the incorrupt cluster did ripen draw nigh, coming to give birth unto him that poured forth the wine of gladness and watered us that cry out to him, O God of our Father, blessed art thou. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, the divine vial which beareth within herself the fragrant myrrh, cometh to pour it out in the cave of Bethlehem, filling with thy mystic fragrance them that chant, O God of our Father, blessed art thou. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. The tongue which Isaiah the prophet beheld of old cometh, holding in her womb Christ, the divine ember, which burneth up all the fuel of sin and enlighteneth the soul of the faithful.
Thy youths brought up together in godliness, scorning the impious decree, hear not the threat of
Children bless you, priests praise you, people exalt him supremely for all ages. Glory, Lord, to the holy resurrection. Oh, that ineffable condescension towards us sinners, O Christ. For though having tasted death, though thou art immortal God, thou wast laid in the tomb as a man, but thou didst rise again, O Word, raising with thyself them that were below, and that exalt thee supremely for all ages. Glory, Lord, to the holy resurrection. Every ear is struck with awe at how the Most High willingly came to earth to destroy the power of hell with his cross and burial, and how he has raised all with himself to cry, children bless, priests praise, people exalt him supremely for all ages. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. Prefiguring thy sacrifice, O Christ, Abraham, obedient to thee, O Master, went forth with faith, wishing to sacrifice on the mountain the son whom he had begotten. But he returned with him, rejoicing and glorifying and exalting above all thee, the deliverer of the world. Holy fathers, pray to God for us. When thou didst robe thyself in ever-blazing flame as in a divine robe, O Christ, thou didst utterly extinguish the fire for the three holy children, and by thy descent the dew has cried out unto them that chant, priest him, and exalt him supremely forever. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. The prophet Daniel is given to the lions as an unjust trial, but through the precept of abstinence in his piety, he had the wild beasts as fellow fasters in the depths of the pit. Through his prayers and those of Abraham and the children, save them that hymn thee in the world of Christ. Most holy Theotokos, save us. The voices of the prophets faithfully proclaimed him as Jesus Emmanuel, who comes in human form, God and man. And the Virgin Mary, without having known a man, gives birth in the city of Bethlehem unto a son, the co-on originate word through the Holy Spirit.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, in gladness. Let us cry out with the angels, glory to God in the highest. The Savior is born, the Master cometh, whom the star doth indicate. The Magi hasten to behold him, a babe in a manger. Let all creation bless the Lord and exalt him supremely for all ages. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. Amongst slaves wast thou enrolled of thine own will, O Master, subjecting thyself to the law of Caesar, that thou mightest free mankind from slavery to the evil one, O most merciful God. Wherefore, rejoicing, we chant that all creation bless the Lord and exalt him supremely for all ages. Let us bless the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O unoriginate Word, I bear thee as a newborn babe, although I have no wise, no man, said the Virgin, marveling. Whom on earth can I name thy father? I know not. Wherefore, withal, I chant to thee, let all creation bless the Lord and exalt him supremely for all ages. We praise, bless, and worship the Lord, and seeing him, blessing, exalting him above. We praise, bless.
We sure do. We praise, bless, and worship the Lord, we sing and exalt him above all forever.
Thank you.
Into which it had descended.
is God everlasting. Shall I exalt with glory them that magnify thee with faith and love? Glory, O Lord, of the holy resurrection. Why dost thou lament, O creation, beholding the bestower of life as immortal upon the cross and in the tomb? For he shall rise again, renewing thee with light. With his resurrection on the third day has he cast down Hades, and raised up with himself the dead that praise him. Glory, O Lord, of the holy resurrection. Even though thou didst go down in the grave as one dead, O Christ, bestower of life, yet thou didst destroy the might of Hades, and raising up with thyself the dead which it had swallowed up in the past, as God thou didst give resurrection unto them that magnify thee with faith and love. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. Celebrating the feast of the fathers that were before the law, let us honor Christ, who in godly manner is begotten of them in the flesh. For Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who through faith are proclaimers of the Spirit and grace, are shown to be the foundation of the prophets and the law. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. God, who by the fire and the bush showed to Moses the godly mystery in manner past understanding, having descended into the fire for the children, showed the flame of the furnace to be due through the fire of the essence of his divinity. Holy Fathers, pray to God for us. The all-holy children assembling with Abraham and Daniel, the wondrous prophet of God, Isaac and Jacob with Moses and Aaron, faithfully join chorus before the Nativity of Christ, praying unceasingly that we may say, Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and most holy Theotokos, save us. All of creation rejoices in thy birth-giving, O Virgin, for Bethlehem has opened Eden unto us, and lo, delighting in the tree of life, we all earnestly cry out in faith, Thou hast fulfilled our prayers, O Mistress.
Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O mystery, strange, awesome, and most glorious, the Lord of glory hath come to earth. And having beggared himself, he hath entered a cave in the flesh, seeking to restore Adam and to deliver Eve from her pain. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee. By thy swaddling clothes thou dost loose the bonds of our sinful fall. By thy great poverty thou dost enrich us all, O compassionate one. And having been laid in a manger of dumb beasts, thou dost release me from irrational malice, O all unoriginate word of God. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. The preaching of the prophets hath reached the ends of the earth, for they foretold him that was to come in the fullness of time. And he came and appeared incarnate of the pure Virgin. Him let us receive with a pure mind.
What a strange and wonderful mystery I see. The cave is heaven, the Virgin, the cherubim's throne, the manger, the place in which Christ the God, whom nothing can contain, is laid. In we praise and magnify.
Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Holy is the Lord our God. Holy is the Lord our God. Holy is the Lord our God. Exalt the Lord our God, and worship at his full of soul, for he is holy.
From the seed of Abraham and the divine forefather David is the all-unoriginate word brought forth, who of old wondrously saved the youths equal in number to the Trinity by the descent of the angel into the flame, and who transformed the lamentation of the myrrh-bearing women into joy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
No, never, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Be glad, O Bethlehem, and you, O Ephrata, make ready. For the Theotokos come to the cave in the manger to give birth ineffably unto God. O dread mystery, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and all the patriarchs and prophets, angels, and men, now radiantly celebrate the four feasts of his divine advent.
Praise the Lord from the heavens, praise him in the highest, praise him all his angels, praise him all his hosts, praise him sun and moon, praise him all you stars of light, praise him you heaven of heavens and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he spoke and they came to be, commanded and they were created. He established them forever, yea, forever and ever. He has made a decree which will not pass away. Praise the Lord of the earth, you dragons and all deeps. Fire, hail, snow, and frost, stormy wind, fulfilling his word. Mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars. Beasts and all kind of creeping things and feathered birds. Kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all judges of the earth. Young men and maidens, old men and children. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His
His glory is on earth and in heaven, and he has exalted the horn of his people. All his saints will praise him, even the children of Israel, the people near to him. Sing to the Lord a new song of his praise in the congregation of the saints. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him, let the sons of Zion rejoice in their king. Let them praise his name with the dance, let them sing praises to him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord takes pleasure in his people, he will exalt the meek and save them. Let the saints be exalted in glory, they will rejoice in their beds. The praises of God shall be in their mouths and to have swords in their hands, to execute vengeance on the nations and chastisement on the people, to bind their kings with fetters and their nobles with chains of iron, to execute on them the judgment that is written, such is the glory of all his saints.
Lift up your voice, O Zion, the divine city of God. Proclaim the divine memory of the fathers. Honor with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. One whose memory is eternal. For behold, with Judah and Levi we magnify Moses the great.
Incomprehensible and indescribable one in the flesh, and she comes. To the Father and to the Son.
the sins that I sinner have committed this day in deed, word, and thought, and with all my senses.
May God forgive you and have mercy on you, Holy Mother. Bless me, Holy Mother, and forgive all the sins I have committed this day in deed, word, and thought, and with all my senses, and pray for me.
Amen.